السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome back to our lessons after our very long break. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all, inshallah. So, we are discussing about the causes of fabrication. What caused a person to fabricate? What gave him that audacity to fabricate something against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? We mentioned that the first reason, it was due to political reasons. In this year commenced right after the demise of or the martyrdom of Uthman radiallahu anhu. So هو أول معنى طرقه الواضعون وفضائل ال... Sorry, I forgot it. Let me just check here. So on page 96. وأول معنى طرقه الواضعون هو فضائل الأشخاص. You got that there on page. That's supposed to be the point which you highlighted and memorized. See, I forgot it to teach you that you're supposed to memorize that. The very first cause which caused the very first thing that people started to fabricate about was on the virtues of a people. So people would fabricate something to support who they assumed was the leader. Those who supported Ali radiallahu anhu, they fabricated narrations on the virtues of Ali radiallahu anhu. And then those who supported Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu in turn, they fabricated in support of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Thereafter, we commenced with this quotation of Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah. So now we're on midway page 97. Isn't it? That's where I remembered. You can see how weak my memory is. I even forgot that portion which I wanted to quote. So if it's wrong, you can just let me know. It's Ya Watala Ibn al-Jawzi. So Watala Ibn al-Jawzi Ibn Abil Hadid Adib al-Shi'a wal-Mu'tazila fi zamanihi. That after Ibn al-Jawzi rahimullah, the next person to speak about all of these fabrications was Ibn Abi al-Hadid. So this is Izzuddin Abdullah Hamid Ibn Hibatullah Ibn Abi al-Hadid. Those of you who, if you read any books on Shi'ism and if you studied a little bit about the Shi'as, then you will know him. For those of you who are studying Muqaddama Ibn al-Salah, for context, he died in the year 656. So it was 13 years after the demise of Ulama Ibn al-Salah rahimullah. So basically, he was living around that time. And he was a very eloquent person from amongst the Shi'as and the Mu'tazilites in his time. So although Sheikh Abdul Fattah Abu Ghudda, he writes in the footnotes that he passed away in 655, but according to other research, he passed away in 656. And he mentioned, فَقَالَ فِي كِتَابِ شَرْحْ نَهْجِ الْبَلَاغَةِ. So as the name suggests, that this is the commentary of Nahj al-Balagha. And what's Nahj al-Balagha? It's a book that was written by Sharif al-Radi, a famous Shi'i. Basically, he gathered what was assumed to be khutbahs of Ali radiallahu anhu. So it became then a very popular kitab. In fact, they mentioned that there are over like 210 commentaries of this kitab. So his name was Muhammad ibn al-Husayn al-Musami. He was born in 359 and passed away in 406. ما ملخصه سنة. If I'm going to digress, you must please let me know, because if you're going to continue in our same pace like last time, we might only complete this kitab next year. So we're going to go on a faster pace, inshallah, so that we can complete this kitab soon, inshallah. So ما ملخصه بحروفه. Now he's quoting from him that what he mentioned is the summary of what he said. خالت الحديثة كذبٌ كثيرٌ. There was a lot of lies that were diluted with the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. صدر عن قوم قصدوا به الإضلال وتخبيط القلوب والعقائد. It emanated from people who intended to lead people astray and to corrupt hearts and minds. وقصد بعضهم التنويه بذكر قوم كان لهم في التنويه بذكرهم غرض دنيوي. Some of them, they had this ulterior motive. Tanwih means ulterior motive. They had this ulterior motive that if they have to fabricate a hadith, if they have to mention all of these kind of narrations, then they will get some worldly gain. ولم يسكت المحدثون الراسخون في علم الحديث عن هذا. So who's saying this here again? Just remember that it is one of the leading Shias of his time. He's saying that the محدثون, they did not maintain silence. So basically, he is admitting that the محدثون, they did not maintain silence. Those who are firm in their knowledge. بل ذكروا كثيرا من الأحاديث الموضوعة. They mentioned a lot of these fabrications. وبينوا وضعها. They explained how it is fabricated. وأن رواتها غير موثوق بهم. And that the narrators are not reliable. واعلم أن أصل الأكاذيب في أحاديث الفضائل كان من جهة الشيعة. So now he's a Shi'i and he's like we say he's admitting that the very basis of lying in the ahadith of the of fadail of mentioning praises of others emanated from the Shi'as. فإنهم وضعوا في مبدأ الأمر أحاديث مختلفة في صاحبهم. In the very beginning stages, they invented and fabricated numerous ahadith in praises of Ali رضي الله عنه. حملهم على وضعها عداوة خصومهم. And the reason what motivated them and what gave them this audacity of fabricating is the enmity which they had on their opponents. فَلَمَّا رَأَتِ الْبَكْرِيَّةِ بَكْرِيَة means those who follow Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه, those who supported Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه. فَلَمَّا رَأَتِ الْبَكْرِيَّةِ مَا صَنَعَتِ الشِّيعَةِ وَضَعَتْ لِصَاحِبِهَا أَحَادِيثَ فِي مُقَابَلَةِ هَذِهِ الْأَحَادِيثِ. So those in support of Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه, they saw that the Shi'as are fabricating these narrations in support of Ali رضي الله عنه. So to combat them, they fabricated a hadith in support of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. So Shia started, the Bakris responded, فَلَمَّا رَأَتِ الشِّيعَةَ مَا قَدْ وَضَعَتِ الْبَكْرِيَةَ أَوْثَعُوا فِي وَضْعِ الْأَحَادِيثِ. When the Shias now saw that they are also fabricating, they began to fabricate even more. And from there, there were more fabrications and more fabrications and more fabrications. وَلَقَدْ كَانَ الْفَرِيقَانِ فِي غُنْيَةٍ عَمَّكَ تَسَبَاهُ وَجَتَرَحَاهُ. Both parties, whether it was the Shi'as or whether it was the Ahlul Sunnah, those who supported Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, they were not in need of doing all of this, of fabricating and of criticizing the other party. Also, this you can make note of the statement, inshallah, one day when you read more, you will see that there are other views that fabrications did not start as soon as the year 40 Hijrah. There's that view of Sheikh Sanubar, etc. But for now, you can just see that here they're mentioning that the Shias were the ones who started it. وَلَقَدْ كَانَ فِي فضائل علي الثابتة الصحيحة. That why they were not in need to fabricate is because you already have so many ahadith which are authentically proven from Ali رضي الله عنه. وفضائل أبي بكر المحققة المعلومة. Likewise, the fadail of Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه, which are firmly authentically proven from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and are well known. ما يغني عن تكلف العصبية لهما. This year is make has made them independent of partisanship of this bigotry for them. نسأل الله أن يعصمنا من الميل إلى الهوى وحب العصبية. So he makes this dua that Allah Ta'ala should save us from just following our own ego and from loving this عصبية, this partisanship. So we can just skip out the footnotes, what you say, because we're going so slow with the book, so we can go now to the next page. And you can see in the bottom, in the footnote, basically he quotes, وَاخْتَلَفُوا فِي التَّفْضِيلِ. Amongst the Shias, you had this difference between the Basriyun and the Baghdadiyun, that who's better, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu or Ali radiallahu anhu. Now he says, وَقَالَ الشَّيْخُ الْمُحَدِّثُ مَجْدُ الدِّينَ الْفَيْرُوزَابَادِ صَاحِبُ الْقَامُسِ الْمُحِيطِ. So you can see he describes Alama Firozabadi as a muhaddith. And that is why when quoting him, it especially when seeing the meaning of words of ahadith, it's worth it to rather take from his dictionary as well, because he was together with being an expert in language, he was also an expert in hadith, and that is why you see that Mullah Zakaria Kanlawi rahmullah, he quotes a lot when taking when explaining words of a hadith. He quotes from Al Qamus Al Muhit. So nevertheless, he mentions at the end of his other book Sifr Al Sa'ada, وَقَدْ عَقَدَ هَذِهِ الْخَاتِمَةَ الْإِشَارَةَ إِلَى أَبْوَابٍ رُوِيَ فِيهَا أَحَادِيثٌ مَرْفُوعَةٌ إِلَى النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَلَيْسَ شَيْءٌ مِنْهَا بِصَحِيحٍ وَلَا ثَابِتٍ عَنْهُ وَقَدْ كَذَّبَهَا جَهَابِذَةُ عُلَمَاءِ الْحَدِيثِ. So he brought a khatima, he brought a chapter right at the end. And yeah, it is quotes many ahadith which are marfu', they all reach right up until the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So many ahadith, but not one of those narrations are authentic or are firmly established from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says that the senior muhaddith scholars, they have they disbelieved in this these ahadith. They regarded all of these narrations to be false. So he says, وَبَابْ فَضَائِلْ أَبِي بَكْرِنِ الصَّدِّقِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْ أَشْهَرُ الْمَشْهُورَاتِ مِنَ الْمَوْضُوعَاتِ. He's saying that under the chapter on the fadail of Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه, that the most famous from all the fabrications is, like you say, مِثْلُ حَدِيثِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَتَجَلَّى لِلنَّاسِ عَمَّا وَلِأَبِي بَكْرِ خَاصَّةِ. So this here is a narration which has been fabricated, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will expose himself, will make himself manifest to all other people. That means all other people will have to look at Allah ta'ala together from the time of Adam alayhi salam until Qiyamah. But Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he will have this honor, he will have this privilege of seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. In seclusion, he will get to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is a fabrication. Likewise, wa hadith, ma sabba Allahu fi sadri shay'an illa wa sabbahu fi sadri Abi Bakr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not poured anything in my heart except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has poured the same thing in the heart of Abu Bakr. So whatever inspiration I get, Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu, he gets that same inspiration. Wa hadith, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا اشتاق إلى الجنة قبل شيبة أبي بكر. That when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم became desirous of Jannah, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم kissed the white hair of Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه. So all of these are fabrications. وحديث أنا وأبو بكر كفرسي ريحان. So you know the فرسي ريحان is the two horses which you put in, they basically have a competition. So that is how myself and Abu Bakr are like having a competition, who's going to be first. That means like Abu Bakr is, so to say, coming so close to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because the competition is that where the first the person who's taking the first position and the person who's taking the second position is just a few centimeters apart, isn't it? Like the person who took the first position, he put his foot first beyond the line, and that is how he won. And then the person who took the second position, so it's like figuratively trying to say like that, but this here is also a fabrication. وَأَمْ أَثَالِي هَذَا مِنَ الْمُفْتَرَيَاتِ الْمَعْلُومِ بُطْلَانُهَا بِبَدِيهَةِ الْعَقْلِ. He's saying that other fabrications like this, which it's so clearly known that these are all fabricated, if a person just has to use his intellect, and he will clearly see that this cannot be proven. وَبَابُ فَضَائِلِ عَلِي رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهِ. He says, it brings a chapter on the فَضَائِلِ of Ali رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهِ وَمَنْ قُولٌ فِي أَحَادِيثِ لَا تُعَدْ. So many ahadith are narrated in the regarding the virtues of Ali رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهِ. وَمِنْ أَفَضَحِهَا الْأَحَادِيثُ الْمَجْمُوعَ فِي الْكِتَابِ الْمُسَمَّى الْوَصَايَا النَّبَوِيَّ. So there was this book that was written, Al-Wasaya Al-Nabawiyyah. Basically, in this book, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is addressing Ali radiallahu anhu. It's a fabrications, but the ahadith as such, like the fabricated ahadith as such, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling Ali radiallahu anhu. So, وَأَوَّلُ كُلِّ حَدِيثٍ مِّنْهَا يَا عَلِي يَا عَلِي يَا عَلِي. So he's saying that in this entire book, there's only and only one narration that is authentically proven. And that is, Ya Ali, Anta minni bi manzalati Harun min Musa. You are to me on the same status that Harun was to Musa alayhi salam. That's the only proven narration. Everything else is fabricated. وقال الحافظ ابن حجر في مقدمة لسان الميزان وهو يتحدث عن أودية الأحاديث الضعيفة والموضوعة. So in the introduction of Lisan al-Mizan, Hafiz ibn Hajar rahimahullah is speaking about where you will find a lot of weak in mawdu and narrations. So he says, وَأَمَّا الْفَضَائِلِ As for virtues of other people, فَلَا يُحْصَى كَمْ وَضَعَ الرَّافِضَ فِي فَضْلِ أَهْلِ الْبَيْتِ You cannot even count how many narrations the Rawafiz, the Shi'as, they have fabricated in support and regarding the virtues of the Ahlul Bayt. وَعَارَضَهُمْ جَهَلَةُ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ So then, those who are from the Ahlul Sunnah, they paid them back by fabricating on the fadail of Muawiyah radiallahu anhu. This is how they combated them. بدءاً وبفضائل الشيخين So initially they only would fabricate in support of Muawiyah رضي الله عنه Thereafter they began to even fabricate in support of Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه and Umar رضي الله عنه وقد أغناهما الله وأعلى مرتبتهما عنها Allah سبحانه وتعالى has made both of them independent of this and Allah سبحانه وتعالى has raised the status even higher than this ومما وضع في هذا الصدد And other narrations which have also been fabricated regarding this hadith is the narration Aliyun khayrul bashar man aba faqad kafar. So this here it's a fabrication saying that Ali is the best of all people. If anyone doubts it, then he has committed kufr. وحديث ما في الجنة شجرة إلا مكتوب على كل ورقة منها لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله أبو بكر الصديق وعمر الفاروق وعثمان ذو النورين that, so this here is another fabrication that on every leaf of the trees of Jannah it's written this, these words لا إله إلا الله أبو بكر he is the صديق so أبو بكر is the مبتدأ الصديق the خبر عمر is the مبتدأ فاروق is the so أبو بكر الصديق عمر الفاروق عثمان ذو النورين so that is a all fabrications وحديث أبو بكر يلي أمتي بعدي that أبو بكر رضي الله عنه he's after me he's going to rule over this أمه so that's a fabrication وحديث علي أول من آمن به that Ali is the first person to Believe in me. Now, you know the word Faruq is used for Umar radiallahu anhu. So they use this here and they said, وَهُوَ فَارُوقُ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ They're giving the title which Umar radiallahu anhu became commonly known with. They're giving the title to who? To Ali radiallahu anhu. وَهُوَ خَلِيفَتِي مِنْ بَعْدِهِ وَحَدِيثُ الْأُمَنَاءُ الثَّلَاثَةَ There are three people who you could be trusted, who are the most trustworthy, Ana, so the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Jibreel, and Muawiyah. So can you see these kind of fabrications just because of the politics that were happening at that time? So who the governor who they supported, they would fabricate in support of him. وقد استمر الوضع لدعم الرؤساء والملوك والفضلاء إلى عهد الخلافة العباسية. So it started yeah from after the demise after the martyrdom of Uthman رضي الله عنه in the year 40 هجرة and it continued right until the Abbasid dynasty. وصنع في تأبيدها and أحاديث were forged to show that that Khilafat must remain perpetually. وامتداد بقائها and it will continue to remain إلى قيام الساعة until the day of قيامة. أحاديث كثيرة that's أحاديث كثيرة it's the So there were many ahadith which were forged, which were made up to show that their dynasty, that their kingdom will remain until the day of Qiyamah. He said that these are such narrations, يتقزز القارئ من كثرتها وبرادتها. يتقزز means to feel disgusted. You know, when a person, he feels like vomiting. That he feels like spewing. In Arabic, they use the word taqazzaza. So you can see, like when you read all of this here, it just makes you feel so, it makes you feel so bad. It changes your whole mood, basically. How many narrations like this here were fabricated? Was tawfat bayanaha kutub al-mawdu'at. If you go to the books on fabrications, you will find so many narrations like this. فَأَغْنَى ذَلِكَ عَنْ ذِكْرِ شَيْءٍ مِّنْهَا هُنَا So because there are so many narrations mentioned there, it makes us independent of quoting all of that narrations here. So all this was the first thing that motivated people to fabricate. What was it? It was due to the politics of the time. So for political reasons, people took the audacity to fabricate. That was the first reason. Now we're going to the second reason. So you can see Sheikh Abdul Fattah Bughadda basically went into so much detail explaining this first reason. So one day when you're teaching a book on Usul al-Hadith, then they just mentioned first reason, second reason, third reason. Then here you got your whole commentary. So you can come read all of this, whatever points you learned here, then you can mention it to your students. So that was the first reason. Now the second reason is al-adawatu lil-Islam, deenan wa dawlatan. That those who were enemies of Islam, whether they were enemies or whether they had this hatred for Muslims because the Muslims were ruling, or whether they just hated this religion of Islam, so they would then fabricate a hadith. So ويدخل في هذه العداوة أهل الزندقة وغيرهم من يهود ومجوس وحاقدين مندسين في الإسلام. That who is incorporated in this adawa, in this enmity, it's the zindiqs, and we mentioned who's a zindiq previously. If you went through, you'll remember who those are. وغيرهم and others are the Jews, the fire worshippers, and those who hated the Muslims, but they integrated and they became connected, and they became so connected. So this word, you know, now the Arabic language is such that in this from Baba in Fi'al, it means that you integrate in such a way that you get camouflaged, that you get concealed, like people will now assume like you're part of those people. So they became such that they integrated with the Muslims that people assume that they are also Muslims. وَقَدْ تَفَنَّنَ هَؤُلَاءِ الْأَعْدَاءُ بِأَلْوَانِ الْوَضْعِ فِي الْحَدِيثِ كُلَّ التَّفَنُّنِ. You see that these enemies, they use different styles in the way that they would fabricate. لِلنَّيْلِ مِنَ الْإِسْلَامِ وَأَهْلِهِ, to attack Islam as the religion and the Muslims. فَوَضَعُوا مَا يَتَّصِلُ بِذَاتِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. So at times they fabricated that which is connected to the ذات of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والملائكة والسماوات, I don't have to translate all of this, والأرضين والنبوة والعقيدة والعبادة والشرع والعقل والمأكولات والمشروبات والملبوسات والحيوانات. You can see they're fabricating on all of these also. The benefits of this, if you eat this, then this is the benefit. If you drink that, if you wear these kind of clothes, even the benefits of animals, because remember that they are enemies of Islam, so they want to show that look, your Nabi is busy teaching people thus, like he came, you are sent to teach people Islam, and he's busy teaching people what's the benefit of eating that and what's the harms of drinking this, and how good this animal is. Well, jamadat wal qabr wal hashr, you know, everything they fabricated, every topic you can think of, in aqidah, in just general things of this world, wal jannah wal nar wal dunya wal akhirah, everything. And then also when they speaking, when they fabricating, if you do this, you're going to get that kind of rewards and you will be saved from the fire of jahannam. So all these kinds of fabrications, hatta wada'u fil adasi wal basali wal karasi wal baqilla, they even fabricated on the virtues of lentils and onions and leek and broad beans. So and these things also they fabricated. So they left no stone unturned. Like they just felt whatever, because they had no fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They did not fear that warning of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And their whole objective was to harm the Muslims and to turn people away from Islam. So that is why they took the liberty and they just like whatever came in their minds, they would just say it and then attribute to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He again quotes from Majduddin Firozabadi at the end of Zifru Sa'ada. He mentions wababu fazl al adas wal baqilla wal jubn, you know, jubn means cheese, wal jawz walnuts, wal badinjan, the broad beans, wal rumman pomegranates, wal zabib raisins. So the virtues of all of these things, he says lam yasih fihi shay, there are no authentic narrations with regards to these. وإنما وضع الزنادقة في هذه الأبواب أحاديث. That the atheists, they are the ones who fabricated many ahadith regarding all of this. وأدخلوها في كتب المحدثين شينا للإسلام خذلهم الله تعالى. They added it in the books of the muhaddith. Why? Because they wanted to do disgrace Islam, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala humiliated them. Now Sheikh Abdul Fattah Bughadda is saying that he's going to give you some examples. وَأَسُوقُوا هُنَا نَمَاذِجْ مِنْ هَذِهِ السَّخَافَاتِ الَّتِي وَضَعُوهَا. I'm going to now cite some examples just to show you how foolish It was what they fabricated. هزءاً بالدين, just to make a mockery of Islam, وكيداً للإسلام والمسلمين, as a plot against Islam and the Muslim, وتضليلاً لضعفاء العقول المغفلين, and to lead astray those who had weak minds and who were negligent. فمنها في ذات الله تعالى مثل, so he's saying that look, against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they fabricated narrations like this. ربنا من ماء مرور, that our Lord is from salty water, لا من أرض ولا سماء, he's not from the earth nor he's from the heavens. خلق خيلا, he created a horse, فأجراها, and then he made that horse run, فعرقت, so that horse started to perspire, فخلق نفسه من ذلك العرق. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created himself from that perspiration of that horse. Logically, this does not make sense, isn't it? But this is how they fabricated, like so foolish. That is why he's using the word sakhafa. Sakhafa is like you can translate it as stupidity, like, you know, it's like a low word to show that it's like so foolish. It's that any person who reads this here will understand that this here is this contradiction here. Firstly, how can Allah Ta'ala create if he's not created himself? He created the horse and then this horse had to sweat. Then only he managed to create himself. It doesn't make sense at all. It's against logic. And it's very, very clearly apparent that this is a silly statement. وحديث رأيت ربي بالمنى يوم النفر على جمل أورق. So I saw my Lord in Mina on a horse that was green, عليه جبة صوف أمام الناس, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he had a cloak of wool, and he was in front of all the people. Again, this here is a fabrication. وحديث إن الله لما خلق الحروف سجدت الباء ووقفت الألف. Now, does this make sense even? It isn't ألف, it's a letter which is standing, and a ba is lying down. So he's saying, so they fabricated on that also. Like so foolish things, it's like mockery. That is why they fabricated this to mock against the Muslims. They took your Nabi is uttering things like this, like they want to laugh against the Muslims. So they fabricate and then they can make a mockery, they can laugh and they can make jokes of the Muslims, they can scoff at the Muslims. That when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the letters of the alphabet, then ba went into sajda. That is why ba is lying down. Wa waqafatil alif, and alif stood in qiyam, so that is why alif is standing. Wa mina fi fadlil adasi wal fuli wal harisati wal bazinjan. So then they also fabricated for lentils and for beans, and harissa, you know, it's that sweet dish that you make. Well, badinjan, and these beans, wasawaha min al-bukul wa al-at'ima, and other vegetables and foods. Wa fadli dik, even virtues of a rooster. Wal khilafati al-abbasiyya, and the virtues of the Abbasid dynasty. Wal i'tiqad bil ahjar, and having one's reliance and having firm belief in stones. So these are the kind of things which they fabricated. So he says, look, for example, the narration, alaykum bil adas fa innahu mubarakun yuraqqiqu al-qalb wa yukthiru ad-dam'a quddisa ala lisani 70 nabiyyan. That eat lentils. Why? Because it is blessed. It makes the heart soft. It increases your tears. So that means it becomes very easy to cry if you have to eat. Quddisa, and it has been blessed blessed on the tongues of 70 anbiya. Likewise, al-bazinjan lima okilala. So you know when you learn tibbun nabawi, when you're learning about those ahadith where Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recommended cures. So generally when you're studying to become a hakim or you're studying, then you learn all of this. You have to be so careful on what is fabricated narrations, because you will find these kind of things, and then mentioning a particular herb or some vegetable and mentioning the virtues of it. So you just have to make sure that you don't then assume that this is the benefit of it. And that is why in all the commentaries of hadith, even for honey, it comes that so honey is praised in the Quran, but even on that they say that you must discuss first with your doctor on how much you should be taking. So on so much, the muhaddithun would emphasize on this point, that don't become your own doctor just because of reading these ahadith. Probably the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at that particular time, and it was specific to that instance, for that specific person, the Prophet ﷺ recommended that he must eat that and he will find cure. So it's not just a general ruling that anybody can eat it and then anybody will gain cure. It was a very specific. وحديث لا تصب الديك فإنه صديقي, that don't sway or don't speak ill of a rooster because a rooster is my friend. ولو يعلم بنو آدم ما في صوته, if the human beings knew what is in its voice, لشتروا ريشه ولحمه بالذهب, they would have purchased its feathers and its meat in exchange of gold. So of course, this here is a fabrication. Likewise, the narration, لو أحسن أحدكم ظنه بحجر لنفعه. If any of you have to make his thoughts good about a stone, if he has to think good about the stone, and he starts to put his reliance on the stone, then that stone will benefit him. وحديث إن هذا الأمر إذا وصل إلى بني العباس لا يخرج عنهم حتى يسلموه إلى عيسى بن مريم أو المهدي. So you can see this year is in praise of the Abbasi rulers, that once this khilafah goes to the Abbasids, then no one will be able to take it away from them until they give it and hand it over to عيسى عليه السلام or to Imam Mahdi. So of course you can see it's a fabrication because history has proven that's wrong, isn't it? إلى غير ذلك من الخرافات الباردة والضلالات المكشوفة. Many other lame fairy tales like this. So خرافات الباردة is lame fairy tales. والضلالات المكشوفة, an open, very apparent astrayness. التي وضعوها كيدا للإسلام وإذاء للمسلمين. They forged all of these. They fabricated it. They made it up as a plot against Islam and to harm the Muslims, وَتَسْخِيفًا لِلْعُقُولِ وَالْأَذْهَانِ, and to make a mockery of the people's brains and their intellect. قَالَ حَمَّادُ بْنُ زَيْدِ. Now he wants to just show you the amount and the number of narrations that they fabricated. It was no small number. Because anything comes to their mind, they just fabricated and they attributed to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So حَمَّادُ بْنُ زَيْدِ, who was an Abdal, he said, وَضَعَتِ الزَّنَادِقَ عَلَى النَّبِيَ صلى الله عليه وسلم 14,000 حَدِيثٍ, that they fabricated 14,000 أحاديث. And Abdul Karim ibn Abi al-Awja, he was one of the atheists, one of the zindiqs of the time. لما أخذ وأتي به إلى محمد بن سليمان بن علي أمير البصر, when he was caught and he was brought before the governor of Basra in the year 160, so then they said that he must be crucified, he must be hanged, وأمر or that he must be his neck must be chopped off. So he said, والله لقد وضعت فيكم 4,000 حديثا أحرم أربعة آلاف حديث أحرم فيها الحلال وأحلل فيها الحرام. I fabricated 4,000 ahadith, and in those 4,000 ahadith, I have made that which is permissible, I made it impermissible, and that which is impermissible, I have made it permissible. So many ahadith fabricated like this. وقد كان سيف الإسلام لهؤلاء الزنادقة بالمرصاد, but the sword of Islam was waiting in the ambush. فقص رقابهم, so it slaughtered off their necks. وأقام فيهم حكم الله بالقتل والتنكيل, and they established the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by either killing these fabricators or by giving them such a punishment that they could serve as a warning and as an example for other people. ونهض العلماء بتتبع تلك الأحاديث, then the ulama, they stood up and they rose to now study all of those narrations. وكشفوها حديثا حديثا, they looked through each and every narration, they inspected it. ونخلوها حرفا حرفا, they surfed through all of them letter by letter, and they took out all the interpolations, all the misquotes, all the fabrications, حفظا من الله لدينه وسنة نبيه عليه الصلاة والسلام. This year is the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his own religion and for the sunnah of his prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. حكى الحافظ الذهبي في تذكرة الحفاظ وغيره في غيرها. Imam Zahabi, he mentioned in تذكرة الحفاظ وغيره في غيرها. Other scholars, they mentioned in other books. عن ابن علي وإسحاق ابن Ibrahim قال these two people, he said أخذ هارون الرشيد زنديقا. So one day هارون الرشيد ruler, he got hold of one of these زنديقs and he issued the verdict that this person here, his neck must be chopped off. فقال له الزنديق. So the زنديق said لما تضرب عنقي, why are you cutting off my neck? So هارون رشيد responded لأريح العبادة منك, so that I can give people relaxation from you, I can free people from you, the people can now find comfort with you no more being there. So then this person responded and said يا أمير المؤمنين أين أنت من ألف حديث. That now what you're going to do, there's 1,000 narrations, this is according to the one narration. According to the next narration, 4,000 حديث, that the 4,000 narrations وضعتها فيكم, that I fabricated amongst you. أحرم فيها الحلال وأحلل فيها الحرام, that I have made permissible impermissible and the impermissible I have made that permissible. ما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم منها حرفا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did not mention anything from there. He's saying you're killing me, but now this 1,000 or 4,000 narrations are in circulation, so what are you going to do about that? So maybe he thought that the ruler will tell him, okay, no problem, you can go and you are freed and you must now tell us about these 4,000 narrations. But Harun Rashid told him, أين أنت يا عدو الله من أبي إسحاق الفزاري وعبد الله بن المبارك ينخلانها نخلا فيخرجانها حرفا حرفا. That what are you going to do? You have Abu Ishaq al-Fazari and Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak. They will sift through these narrations and they will purify it and they will take out the correct narrations word for word. That means or you can say that فَيُخْرِجَانِ حَرْفًا حَرْفًا, they will take out and they will remove these narrations, each and every letter that you fabricated, they will remove it. So you can see on the one hand you had those who were fabricating left, right and center, they went to town fabricating, they didn't mind fabricating on any topic, whether it's against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether it's making mockery on anything, they just fabricated. But on the other hand you had this kind of muhaddithun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created such giants so that they could then sift through the narrations and they could make sure that hadith is preserved in its pristine purity. وَهَكَذَا أَقَامَ اللَّهُ لِدِينِهِ حَرَّاسًا فِي كُلِّ عَصْرٍ. In this way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala establishes for his deen those who will protect his deen in every era. يَنْفَوْنَ عَنْهُ إِنْتِحَالَ الْمُبْتَلِينَ وَزَيْغَ الزَّائِغِينَ. That they will remove from this deen whatever people falsely attribute, those who want to bring down the deen, what they falsely attribute to the deen, and the strayness of those who are astray. So now he quotes from Ibn Abi Hatim, he mentioned in his book Al-Jarh wa Ta'dil from Abdat ibn Sulaiman, that he said that it was mentioned to Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak, Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak rahimahullah, هذه الأحاديث المصنوعة, so many distorted, fabricated narrations, that there's so many ahadith which have been made up and now they are circulated. Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak rahimahullah responded and said يَعِيشُ لَهَا الْجَهَابِذَ إِنَّا نَحْنَ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكَّرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. That the experts will love and they will purify the ahadith from all of those fabrications. And then he quoted this verse that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken the responsibility upon himself to preserve. وروى ابن أبي حاتم أيضا في كتابه المذكور عن يحيى بن يمان قال إن لهذا الحديث رجالا. For this ahadith there are men, خلقهم الله عز وجل منذ يوم خلق السماوات والأرض. That Allah سبحانه وتعالى has, so to say, specifically created these men to protect the ahadith from the time when Allah سبحانه وتعالى created the heavens and the earth. وإن وكيعا منهم, and وكيع is one such person. And Imam Waqi' rahimahullah is one such person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him specifically so that he can safeguard and protect and purify the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that is the second reason why people would fabricate. So the first reason was political reasons. The second reason was enmity against Islam and the Muslims, whether it was because of their religion or whether it was because of them ruling. Now the third reason, what motivated people to fabricate and what gave them this audacity and what caused them to lie against the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. العصبية للجنس والقبيلة واللغة والبلد والإمام. When they have this prejudice, this you know, overwhelming love, whether it is for a particular nation, whether it's for some tribe, whether it is for one language, whether if it is for a specific city, or whether it is for one ruler. So when these people have this bigotry, when they have this kind of extreme love, then they fabricate in support of it. So this here is like different from the first. In the first, it was political reasons. Yeah, it's just because they love that place so much. So because they love that place so much, so now they fabricate a hadith for the place. They love that person so much. So because they love that person, they fabricate. So he says, before explaining it, that مرض العصبية للباطل قل أن تسلم منه أمة من الأمم. The sickness of bigotry and having prejudice for that which is invalid, it's there's hardly any nation that has been saved from it. Every nation you go to, that they will have this year where they are prejudiced against others, where they have this asabiya, where they love their own clan, they like their own tribe, they like their own heritage, their own culture, and then they hate everyone else. They hate. They have this literal hatred for those who are not part of this culture or part of this tribe. So he said, فَقَدْ وَضَعَ الشَّعْبِيُّونَ, that those people, وَهُمْ مَنْ يَحْتَقِرُونَ أَمْرَ الْعَرَبِ, those people would look down upon the Arabs. They have fabricated a hadith فِي ذَمِّ العرب ومدح أنفسهم وشأنهم. A hadith criticizing the Arabs and praising themselves and all their doings. ومما وضعوه من ذلك حديث إن الله إذا غضب أنزل الوحي بالعربية وإذا رضي أنزل الوحي بالفارسية. So one fabrication, an example of what they fabricated, is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes angry, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends down revelation in Arabic. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends down revelation in Farsi. So this year, as you can see, because they were Persians, so they had this hatred against the Arabs, and they wanted to exalt themselves. They wanted to show how great they are. So they are saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends revelation in Persian. But now what did the Arabs do? فَقَابَلَهُمْ جَهَلَةُ الْعَرَبِ بِالْمِثْلِ. The ignorant Arabs, they responded to them by also fabricating. فَوَضَعُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا غَضِبَ أَنزَلَ الْوَحْيَ بِالْفَرْسِيَّةِ وَإِذَا رَضِيَ أَنزَلَ الْوَحْيَ بِالْعَرَبِيَّةِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he becomes angry, then he sends down revelation in Persian. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends down revelation in Arabic. وَمِمَّا وَضِعَ فِي هَذَا الصَّدَدْ حَدِيثٌ أبغض الكلام إلى الله الفارسية وكلام الشيطان الخوزية وكلام أهل النار البخارية وكلام أهل الجنة العربية وأن سؤال القبر بالسريانية. So that means that hadith which were fabricated against all other languages. So that the worst of all languages is the Farsi language. The language of Khawziyah, that's another language in the East, this year is the language of the Shaitan. And the language of the people of the fire is that in Bukhara what they speak. And the language of the people of Jannah will be Arabic. And in the grave, people will be questioned in a Syrian dialect. So you can see these kind of narrations were fabricated against languages even. Likewise, they fabricated in praises of particular localities and certain cities. So for example, they fabricated this narration, yeah, أَرْبَعَةُ أَبْوَابٍ مِّنْ أَبْوَابِ الْجَنَّةِ, that there are four doors which are doors of Jannah, مُفَتَّحَةٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا, which are open in this world. أَوَّلُهُنَّ الْإِسْكَنْدَرِيَّةِ, the first is in Alexandria, they in Egypt, وَعَسْقَلَان, and then عَسْقَلَان, and then قَزْوِين. If you want to know where قَزْوِين, so he explains it there, it's in Iran. And then he says, وَفَضْلُ جُدَّ عَلَى هَؤُلَىٰ, so the benefit and the greatness of Jeddah over all of these places, كَفَضْلِ بَيْتِ اللَّهِ الْحَرَامِ عَلَى سَائِرِ الْبُيُوتِ, is like the greatness of the Masjid al-Haram over all other houses in this world. So can you see, they're trying to show that Jeddah is such an important city. Likewise, in other narration, أربع مدائن من مدن الجنة في الدنيا. There are four cities which are cities of Jannah in this very world. So it's Makkah والمدينة وبيت المقدس ودمشق. So these four cities. وأربع مدائن من مدن النار في الدنيا. And four cities are cities of the hellfire in this world. القسطنطينية والطبرانية والأنطاكية المحترقة وصنعاء. So you can see that two of them in Turkey, then Tabrania and Sana'a in Yemen. وأن منشأ المياه العذبة الطيبة والرياح اللواقح من تحت صخرة بيت المقدس. And the source of getting nice, sweet, delicious water and cool breezes is under the rock in بيت المقدس. So this kind of ahadith they fabricated. ومما وضعوه في شأن بعض الأئمة ذمًا ومدحًا. Then they also fabricated sometimes in support of a particular scholar and sometimes criticizing a particular scholar. So for example, يكون في أمتي رجل يقال له محمد بن إدريس أضر على أمتي من إبليس. أستغفر الله. So this kind of a narration against Imam Shafi'i رحمه الله. ويكون في أمتي رجل يقال له أبو حنيفة هو سراج أمتي. A few pages I had, Sheikh Abdul Fattah Abu Ghudda will explain it. Now you can't criticize a madhab because people in the madhab, they fabricated like this, yeah? Inshallah, when we come to that, to those pages, they will explain it. وَهَكَذَا وَضَعُوا أَحَادِثِ فِي فَضْلِ بَعْضِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الْعَبَّاسِيِّينَ. So some of the rulers from the Abbasis, they fabricated a hadith for them. وَأَحَادِثِ فِي ذَمِّ التَّرْكِ وَالْحَبْشَ وَالسُّودَانِ. So against the Turks, against the Abyssinians, against those in Sudan, ومدح بغداد والبصرة والكوفة ومرق. So all these cities now, they're praising it, they fabricated a hadith in praise of all of these places. وعسقلان ونصيبين وبعض بلدان المغرب كالمنستير. So this place Munastir, they fabricated numerous ahadith. One such narration is Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, that is they mentioning from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, بساحل أفريقية, by the seashore of Africa, so this is in the west of Africa, باب من أبواب الجنة, there is a door from the door of paradise, يقال له المنستير, that's the name, من دخله فبرحمة الله, ومن خرج منه فبعفو الله. So can you see how they just fabricated like that? And then in the footnote, so in the second paragraph, it says, وَوَضَعُوا فِي فَضَائِلْ بِلَادِ مِنَ الْمَشْرِقِ جُمْلَةٍ مِنَ الْأَحَادِثِ أَيْضًا. That even for many areas in the east, they fabricated a hadith. So for example, in the praises of Bukhara, so حُضَيْفَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ, so this is the fabrication, that سَتُفْتَحُ مَدِينَةٌ بِخُرَاسَان, that there will be this, this place in Khurasan, which is behind a Rava, and that Rava, the name of it is called Jayhun. And the name of this area to Sama Bukhara, it's called Bukhara Mahfufatun bil Rahma. It is surrounded by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Malfufatun bil Malaika. It is enveloped by angels. Mansurun Ahluha. The people therein are all protected. النائم فيها على الفراش كالشاهر سيفه في سبيل الله. A person sleeping in Bukhara is equal to a person in another locality who is has his sword open. A person who has his sword open and he is fighting in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what's the question here? Can Musab explain the fabricated narration about Imam Abu Hanifa and Imam Shafi'i and Imam Abu Hanifa? Basically, the Hanafis, they fabricated against Imam Shafi'i, rahmallah, that yakunu fi ummati rajul. So they fabricated it, they made up this narration, that there will be this person in my ummah whose name is Muhammad ibn Idris. So Muhammad ibn Idris is Imam Shafi'i, eventually you done it last week. Muhammad ibn Idris, Imam Shafi'i, أضرُّ على أمتي من إبليس. He is more harmful upon my ummah than even shaitan. So this is what the Hanafis are fabricating against the Shafi'is, to show that you can't be following Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i. Rather, if you want guidance, then who must you follow? وَيَكُونُ فِي أُمَّتِي رَجُلٌ يُقَالُ لَهُ أَبُو حَنِيفَةٌ. That there will be a person in my ummah whose name is Abu Hanifa. This person, Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, هو سراج أمتي. He is the one who is the lantern for my ummah. So you can see that the whole reason why they're fabricating this here is to show that you mustn't follow the Shafi'i madhab, rather you must follow the Hanafi madhab. So that is the reason why they fabricated this. Now, some people might assume, like Umar Ashqar, he wrote about this here, that, you know, when writing about the tariq of fiqh, so he presented all these kind of examples. That look how to what ta'assub the followers of the madhab they had, that you have that they're actually fabricating a hadith like this. So this is not a valid reason. So like I said, Sheikh Abdul Fattah Bukhuta is going to explain later on why it's not a valid reason. Because then we can say that those people who fabricated against Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, now you're going to criticize Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, and you must going to say that you must no more be part of the Ahlul Sunnah. So you can see, so, but we'll explain it when we come there. Is the language of Jannah being Arabic established through other authentic reports? I'm not so sure. In Jannah is whatever you want to speak, you can speak. Whatever you want to do, you can do. That whatever there is, the haram of this world is halal in Jannah. So whichever language you want to speak in Jannah, you can speak in Jannah. Okay. Everyone's sending direct message. Direct message means that everyone can see the message, or it means that only I can see the message. Briefly remind us the mention of Imam Waqi'ah. So basically Imam Waqi'ah, yes, Waqi'ah ibn al-Jarrah, that he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, basically created him to protect the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If any person need to come and try to fabricate a hadith against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then Imam Waqi'ah would be able to detect that this here is a fabrication. So why are you all making your then messages direct messages? Put it as public instead of making it private. The following question, can you please briefly? Oh, okay, sir, yeah. Yes, it's basically just showing that Allah, on the one end, they're fabricating so much, on the other end, you have like expert muhaddithun, that they would not just let any hadith slip through them. Rather, they would be able to detect that this here is a fabrication. Immediately, they would know that this is a fabrication, and they would warn people, and they would tell people about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala divinely created people like this here, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the responsibility, isn't it, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to protect this deen. And this deen can only be protected if the ahadith is protected. So, and basically you have humankind against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala works what means, without means, and against means. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created muhaddithun like this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would make those muhaddithun come to know of every fabrication. So no fabrication can just go by and be passed on as a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like that, they also fabricated a hadith mu'arraqa bi sanatin mu'ayyana, which is dated to a particular year. So for example, they fabricated this narration that when it's the year 130 Hijrah, now you're going to have that which is isolated and abandoned. So what are going to be isolated and abandoned? Quran and fi jawfin zalim. That the Quran is going to be in the chest of an oppressor. وَمُصْحَفًا فِي بَيْتِ قَوْمٍ لَا يَقْرَؤُونَ فِيهِ. So you can see it's like isolated and abandoned. That zalim is not going to read the Quran, but he'll be a hafiz. It's a fabrication. And then you will have the mushaf, the actual copy of the Quran. This will be amongst people who will not read it. وَرَجُلًا صَالِحًا بَيْنَ قَوْمٍ سُوءٍ. And then you will have the pious person. He is amongst evil people, so he's going to be isolated. He will be abandoned. So that kind of a fabrication. وَهَكَذَا جُمْلَةُ أَحَادِيثِ كَثِيرَةٍ جَاءَ فِيهَا تَوْثِيقُ وُقُوعِ الْحَوَادِثِ عَلَى السِّنِينَ وَالشُّهُورِ. So like this here, many fabrications, they made up and concocted numerous narrations because based on the events of a particular year or in certain months. مثله إذا كانت سنة كذا وكذا وقع كذا وكذا then this year then this is what's going to happen. وإذا كان شهر كذا وكذا وقع كذا وكذا in a particular month this is what's going to happen. So this is how they would fabricate narrations. So that's the third reason. So keep count because there's so much in between, so much commentary in between. So remember again that the first was political reasons. Isn't it? You remember that? The second was adawatun lil Islam deenan wa dawlatan. That enmity for Islam and the Muslims. The third was al-asabiyya lil jinsi wal qabila wal lugha wal baladi wal imam. Where they had this prejudice, where they had this over zealousness and this exaggerated love for a particular clan, for some tribe, for a certain language, for some locality, for some city, or for a imam. Now this is the fourth reason why people would fabricate, and this year it's very important. If you're going into bayans, you know that ulama put in a position where they have to give bayans. So sometimes then what they feel not lazy to prepare, they remember they forward from WhatsApp, so they thought, okay, let me just mention that in my Juma bayan. So that's quoting a fabrication. These people would actually fabricate in the lectures. So القصص والوعد ترغيبا وترهيبا. It whether it was to encourage people to do particular actions, or whether it was to make people scared, to warn them against certain actions. So Sheikh Abdul Fattah Abu Ghudda, he mentions as the introduction here, الوعد للناس والتذكير لهم بالدار الآخرة أمر مطلوب في الإسلام. That giving a lecture to people, reminding them about the akhirah, this is something which is sought, this is something which is meritorious in Islam. وَمُحْتَاجٌ إِلَيْهِ لِإِصْلَاحِ النُّفُوسِ. Actually, it's a necessity so that you can we can rectify ourselves. وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The Quran advises us that we should be encouraging others and we should be giving a reminders. والقائم فيه, but the person who is doing this, the one who is going to be delivering the lecture, ينبغي أن يكون على مشاركة جيدة في العلم. He must have a good level of knowledge. ومعرفة حسنة بالتفسير والحديث والفقه وحكايات الصالحين والزهار ووقائع السلف. And he must have good knowledge on the tafsir of the Quran, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the laws of fiqh, stories, anecdotes of pious people, of those who abstain from this world, and general incidents of the pious predecessors. Together with all of that knowledge, مع التقوى والورع والزهد, he himself must have taqwa. And he himself must fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he himself must be abstaining from this world. وَبَصِيرَةٍ فِي مَا يَقُولُ وَمَا يَدَعُ فِي مَجَالِسِ الْوَضْعِ. He must be able to know what he is mentioning and what he must not mention in these lectures of his. فَإِذَا كَانَ كَذَلِكَ كَانَ وَعُضُهُ مُفِيدًا وَالِجًا فِي الْقُلُوبِ. When he is like this, he has knowledge also and he has piety also. Then his lecture, few words of his, it will penetrate the hearts. وَمُرَقِّقًا, it will make the hearts soft. وَمُثَقِّفًا, it will refine and correct the hearts. وَمُعَلِّمًا مُبَصِّرًا, he will become a teacher, he will give people foresight. كَمَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ التَّابِعِيُّ الْجَلِيلُ عُبَيْدُ بْنُ عُمَيْرَ الْمَكِّهِ. Like this great tabi'i, he was the person who used to give, he was the orator of the people of Makkah in the time of Umar رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. He passed away in the year 68 Hijrah. So وقد اشتهر بمتانة دينه وصلاحه. He was very well known on the strength of his deen, how deep his piety was. But what that, وكان فصيحا بليغا, he was very eloquent as well. He knew how to express himself. يجلس الصحابي عبد الله بن عمر في حلقته. The great sahabi, this person is a tabi'i, but a sahabi, someone who is greater than him, Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله عنه, he would sit in his gathering ويبكي متأثرا بكلامه وإخلاصه. So you can imagine, Abdullah ibn Umar, he would sob, he would cry, he would be deeply impacted by the speech and the ikhlas, the sincerity of this orator. So this is when a person combines knowledge also with piety. So when you give a lecture, then this is what we should do. ولكن المؤسف, but it is so sad, أن غالب الوعاظ قديما وحديثا, that the vast majority of orators, whether it was in the past, whether it's recent, يغلب عليهم الفراغ من تلك الصفات المنيفة. They are bereft of these noble qualities. ويشيع فيهم ضعف العلم. The weakness in knowledge is spread out among them. وفي بضعهم يشيع ضعف العقل والدين. from amongst some of them, they also have weakness in their intellect and they're even weaker in their religion. وَالتَّكَسُبْ بِالدُّرَيْهِمَاتِ So you can see اسم تصغير. Just to get some pennies of this world, تُجْمَعُ لَهُمْ مِنَ الْمُسْتَمِعِينَ So in the past, maybe it happens in some cultures as well, when a person gives a lecture, then they throw some coins at him or they throw some notes at him, they pay him in that way. So just so that he can get earn some extra pennies like this year, this is why he's fabricating. فَيَكُونُ هَمُّهُمْ الْإِتْيَانِ بِغَرَائِبِ الْأَخْبَارِ Now they want to get more and more from the people. So the more that they going to manage to hold the attention of the people, number one, the longer they can keep the audience, the more money they're going to get because people are just throwing and throwing. So instead of throwing for 5 minutes, they'll be throwing cash to them for half an hour. Or the longer that they can impress the audience, the more they're going to get. The person will first throw a one penny, then a two penny, $1, two, like that. He'll start to throw more and more just because it's becoming more and more impacted. وخوارق الأساطير المختلفة الهائلة to put all his fairy tales there التي تجده السامعين which jolts those who are listening وتفتح عند سماعها الأفواه والأذان people are like looking in shock and they like so stunned and mesmerized by the speech وتلعب بعقول الضعفاء البلاهة they play around with the intellect of those who are weak and those who mentally deficient. وَتُبْكِي عُيُونَ السُّخَفَاءِ وَتُحْزِنُ قُلُوبُهُمْ They have this way of talking that they can just move the ignorant people, the foolish people, they can move them into tears and they can like really have an impact on their heart. فَيَكُونُ هَذَا الْوَعْدِ لِلْإِبْتِزَازِ So this word ابتزاز, it's like, you know, Arabic, like we say, it's a rich language. It's one word, but it has the meaning of illegally taking money away from a person. So this is the meaning of ibtizaz. So this lecture, it's a means of illegally taking money from the person. Why? Because you're not giving them any deen. You are just quoting fabrication. So the money which you are taking also, it's illegal. What tasqif and all of this foolishness, la litadhkir wa tasqif. And it's not to remind people, nor is it to rectify the audience. So it's hapas and it's your Maghrib time. So inshallah, we'll pause here and we continue next week, inshallah. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.